Well, you might remember that a while back we had a look at the thorny issue of wind farms and whether or not they're a health hazard. Well, round two in this brewing brawl turns out to be between the developers and landowners. Some farmers are angry. They believe the giant fans are devaluing their land. Environment reporter Emily Rice has been weighing up the pros and the cons.
Expectant parents Gareth and Shondell Price-Jones built their dream home near Crookwell in southern New South Wales with hopes of raising a family close to nature.
The beautiful landscape, the views and the natural beauty and
the farming life.
But wind power has put their plans in a spin. They're among a dozen landholders to receive letters from a developer giving them 3 months to decide between selling up or live under the shadow of a proposed wind farm. This shows how their view could change when between one and three turbines are erected less than a kilometre from their home.
Well, Sean and I were devastated because we don't really know where we're at now. We don't know where our future lies. It's put a lot of stress on us.
A lot of sleepless nights and just the worry of what will happen to our beautiful home.
Crookwell already has 8 turbines, but up to 80 more at twice the height are proposed for the Gullen Range wind farm. Opponents have been to court arguing they'll devalue their properties. Now the developers have to remove turbines impacting on homes or acquire the properties. But Gareth says selling out would destroy a share farm arrangement with his father Humphrey, who lives nearby, and they would struggle to buy a new home in the same price range.
You would be behind the eight ball, maybe $100,000.
Some landholders will host turbines for an annual payment of around $15,000 each. Many don't live on their land, leaving neighbours to suffer the consequences.
All of those families are going to have the very reason they live where they live destroyed by this development.
But not everyone in Crookwell is turned off by the technology.
I think it's a good source of power, as it's clean.
I have no problem with them at all.
The push for more wind farms in Australia is being propelled by the federal government's target for 20% renewable energy by 2020. Right now in Australia, there are 53 wind farms in operation, supplying just 2% of the nation's energy needs. Further west at Boorowa, it's a similar story with 300 turbines proposed.
You can hear the birds now, the crickets, you know. I doubt we'd be hearing them if there were 12 turbines behind us.
Farmers want more transparency from the developers.
It's getting to the stage where they're trying to run and hide from some of the issues that have been raised. Just if there's nothing to hide from, come out. If you're going to hide, well, we're going to find out.
But developers and supporters say wind power is a win for regional Australia.
We expect around $40 million to go into the community during construction. So that translates into real jobs. We expect around 20 jobs full-time once the wind farm's up and running.
But there's always going to be people, no matter what you do, who don't like the project as proposed, and we need to respect that.
Residents are now staging community meetings to air their concerns over property rights.
Australians, they hold their property dearly, and it doesn't matter how modest or grand it might be, it's still your castle.
And on it will go.